Welcome to UFC 269 fight predictions for Oliveira versus Poirier for the lightweight championship. Don't forget to hit that sub button, like, share, and leave me a comment in the comment section below on what your fight predictions are. Hope everyone enjoys the fights. Let's get into it. First fight on the main card, Paiva versus O'Malley. I think the difference is the reach for sure. O'Malley with a 72, Paiva with a 69.5. O'Malley's striking is much cleaner than Paiva. Paiva's going to try to get the fight to the ground. But I think with the footwork of O'Malley, the KO power, just the overall clean striking, I don't think Paiva's going to be able to get him down. And I think O'Malley's going to be able to catch him with something. KO round two. Next up at flyweight, Kai Kara-France versus Cody Garbrandt. This is Garbrandt's flyweight debut. Normally I would go with him because of his footwork and power advantage. But I don't know how depleted he's going to really be. He says he's good, but it's one of them things that until you see it, it's hard to really know. Garbrandt has an 83% KO TKO rating. Kara-France 45%. Significant strikes, 502 for France, 3.17 for Garbrandt. So Garbrandt's going to be looking for the KO. And I think France is also looking for the KO, but he's more of a value. And I think what's going to happen with this fight, I think he's going to be able to push Cody up against the cage and just overall land more value. And I think that's going to end up getting him a decision win. But it's a very hard fight to predict. Next up at welterweight, Jeff Neal versus Santiago Ponzinibbio. Jeff Neal coming off of a loss to Stephen Thompson. And he's been in a little bit of trouble lately from what I understand. But I don't have all the details. So I don't know how focused he is in the fight. But if it wouldn't be for all of those things, I think his power is more than Santiago. Which the stats even show that he gets more KOs, TKOs at 62%. Santiago at 52%. I think he'll be able to land something big on Ponzinibbio, but I don't think he'll be able to get him out of there because it's only a 3-round fight. But I do think Jeff Neal will get a decision win. This fight I can see going either way, but I'm going to go with Jeff Neal decision. Next up for the women's bantamweight title, Amanda Nunes versus Juliana Pena. I really don't see this fight going good for Pena. She's got a good ground game and wrestling base. But I think Amanda's going to be able to keep the fight standing and land big strikes. I think she gets her out of there for KO, TKO, round two. The only way possible I see Pena winning this fight is if she can somehow burn Amanda out and drag the fight into later rounds. But I really just don't see that being a possibility. So I'm going to go with Amanda, KO, TKO, round two. Next up for the UFC lightweight championship, the main event, Charles Oliveira versus Dustin Poirier. Dustin's from Lafayette, Louisiana, which is very close to where I'm from. So I am biased in this pick. And I'm pulling for Dustin to win. Although I'll be sad for Charles because he did grind the hard way to capture UFC gold. The stats, 29% KO ratio for Charles, 54% for Dustin. Submissions, 61% for Charles, 21% for Dustin. 10% decision for Charles, 25% for Dustin. Average fight time, 10 minutes for Dustin, 7 minutes for Charles. But I think the confidence of fighting McGregor twice and all the big wins that Dustin's had lately, when it comes to competition wise, Dustin's fought bigger names. Charles is on a 9 fight win streak, but it's just recent that he started beating highly ranked people. Dustin could have fought for the title way before, but he chose to fight McGregor, which I don't blame him, the big money fight. But I think overall, the cleaner striking and footwork of Dustin is what's going to get him the win. Plus the stamina of going into later rounds. it's rare that you ever see Charles in a five-round fight. But I think the damage that Dustin will be able to land on Charles will start to cause him problems. And I think Dustin's good enough when it comes to the ground game and submission defense to stay away from a lot of Charles's game. Dustin just needs to be cautious of Charles's submission game. Don't leave his neck exposed. But Dustin even admitted in the Khabib fight that he should have just lost the round instead of trying to rush to get up and leaving himself exposed. So I think he's learned a lot when it comes to submission defense, and he won't rush as much. But I think the striking, like I said prior, will start to do a lot of damage to Charles. And I see the fight going a little bit longer than what their average fight time is. So I'm going with Dustin to win a KO, TKO, round 4. Now I'm going to use UFC 4 the game to kind of show you how I see the fight playing out. Let's get into that part of the video.
Coming up next, it's a lightweight championship fight between Charles Duprox Oliveira and Dustin Poirier.
What I am a massive fan first thing of is his striking. Catch him with jabs and then left hook. That's one of Dustin's biggest weapons. And I think early he may be able to catch him and hurt him.
And how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about it.
As the fight progresses, Dustin lands almost 6 strikes per minute. So land a lot of volume and damage, and also go to the body with punches or even knees, but don't throw kicks because then Charles can use that for takedowns. Another thing I can see Dustin using if they're at a close range is leg kicks. He did that really good in the second Conor fight.
In accordance to what he wanted it to be. And at the moment that it showed itself, the moment that the opportunity arrived, he jumped on it, got that big knockdown, and now he finds himself ahead in this fight.
Also, he can use clinching, especially up against the cage, to do a lot of damage.
That it worked so well so early. Great job. Big knee land.
If Charles ends up blocking high, I can see Dustin landing a straight punch.
Scintillating knockout.
Yeah, but the whole fight.
DC, no telestrator tonight, but we're going to get you some highlights from this one.
But it's most likely going to be a check left hook that does the most damage and puts Charles out. And then finish it up with ground and pound.
And that's exactly what he did tonight. He used every bit of his skill to get the job done.
Pretty much same thing, just at a different angle and a different position in the octagon. Left hand, and then follow up with ground and pound.
That ended the fight, but both of these warriors displayed a ton of heart. One guy got the finish, but neither guy should be disappointed in their performance.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 1:10 of round number 4. Declaring the winner by knockout and new UFC lightweight champion of the world, Dustin the Diamond Poirier.
Oh, take my money, DC.
And now I'll go over the predictions again real quick. Paiva versus O'Malley. I got O'Malley KO round 2. Next up at flyweight, Kai Kara France versus Garbrandt. I got France winning the decision. Next up, we got welterweight, Jeff Neal versus Ponzinibbio. Neal by decision. Then we got Amanda Nunes, Juliana Pena. Amanda Nunes KO round 2. And then I got Dustin Poirier winning a 4th round knockout TKO. Hope everyone enjoyed the video. Enjoy the fights. Don't forget to hit the sub, like, share, and leave me a comment in the comment section below on what your fight predictions are. Until next time, I'll catch y'all in the next one. Have a good one.